And I decided to start looking at RVs, and we really kind of like this one that's right behind us right now. We're not sure. We talked to them about numbers already. The numbers are fantastic for us. It's a little longer than I wanted. I didn't want to go over 36 or 37 feet really, but this one's 41 feet.
This one's really calling my name.
But the layout is just phenomenal. So some of the things that we really like about it is the pass-through storage here is just amazing. Pass-through storage is huge.
Open the other side.
I mean,
look how big this is. Holy smokes. Oh, there's Gordon.
So pass-through storage is huge, as you can see. I mean, not that Alice is tall by any means, but she's sitting inside of it, and at 5'2", could almost lay.
I could sleep in here.
She could almost lay down in the width of it.
Yeah.
Front to back, not left to right. Easily on the width, left to right, she'd be able to lay down. And the storage compartment is even heated. There's a heat duct right here. So you wouldn't have to worry about anything on the inside of your front storage getting frozen. That's pretty cool. And you've got some good access to some of your sewer lines. It's carpeted on the side walls, and it's got like a rubberized floor on the inside. So
easy to sweep.
Easy to clean up.
Yep, sweep, yep. Vacuum, whatever.
All right, loops to secure stuff with straps. But yeah, it's pretty cool so far.
As you can see, there's quite a few on the lot here, and we went through basically all of these on here, so it's not like the only one that we looked at. We've definitely looked at a lot today.
It has the heavier, thick, 1-inch doors with good solid slam latches. Magnets to hold the door up when the door's up. 6-point hydraulic leveling system. It has the solid step system from Lippert. Got water on these or something. It has a small storage area right here. It's not real deep, but it's pretty cool.
It's great for the tool bag.
Maybe quick, even a couple of our camp chairs would fit in.
Oh,
here.
Yeah. Quick access stuff. Even our little carpet thing that we put out in front would fit in there.
This storage bay goes all the way from there. It comes through. There's no wall, so you can have a longer item here. It goes all the way to the back. You got a ladder to go to the roof. There's two Whisper Quiet 15,000 BTU air conditioners on top, and
this is my favorite.
When we have company, when we have company, we just
look at that.
Slide out the.
Go ahead, lay on it, hon.
Slide out the hide a bed here.
Look how cool! Look how big this thing is, and he doesn't even fit.
I'm not even close to the
top. Look at that! So, look at all that room.
There's plenty of space there. Certainly not lacking on any kind of storage space in this rig, which I really like. On this side, you have another
same thing there.
Storage compartment, just like what was on the other side. Got your wet bay compartment right here for all the goodies. Looks pretty easy to operate, of course. Clearly marked. So it's pretty awesome. Even a way to put a hose inside. So you've got your electronic leveling system right here. So quick and easy to auto level when you get where you're going. Lippert's a well-known name when it comes to leveling systems.
Okay, now for the fun part. Let's go inside.
It may be a little dark inside because it's not hooked to power yet. But come on in. All right, so huge kitchen. right? Great kitchen island with a probably 70-30 split sink. You've got a nice refrigerator. I think it's 18 cubic foot gas electric refrigerator. Right here, you've got a really nice pantry for all the stuff you want to take with you. Plenty of drawers, cabinets overhead.
That I cannot reach.
And it has this beautiful Furrion cooktop and stove. I mean, it's a 9,000 BTU stainless steel built-in oven. It's just beautiful. In comparison to what we've been using, it's just awesome.
I might be able to make cookies and not burn them.
Right?
Or even biscuits.
And then stepping up here into the, I'll call it living room, because, wow, it's got dual sleeper sofas. I think this is probably a 50-inch TV. It's 4K, ultra-high def, LED TV. Just an enormous space to live in. It has some really nice day-night shades, you know, so you've got a day-night screen that comes down that would just cut a little bit of the sunlight out. And then when it's nighttime and you're ready to go to bed and you want to darken things up, you just pull that shade down. It's really good. Goes up pretty easy. All seems like solid cabinets, solid wood surfaces throughout.
Little fireplace.
With storage. Plenty of places to connect. You've got the theater seats with heat, massage, and the little LED light in front. Now we'll go back to the bathroom real quick. So it's got a nice full-size, I call it full-size, bathroom. I mean, it's not what you're going to get in your house, but, you know, I'm 5'10", 5'11". I've got plenty of head space here to get into the shower. Plenty of room to shower up.
It's just more for me to wash.
More for Alice to wash. But what I do like is it is a one-piece system. It's all one piece. So there's no joints over here or anything for water to seep through. Has a porcelain toilet.
Duck.
Nice little linen closet for us to store stuff in. Towels and all the extras. The sink. Yeah, the sink, I don't... maybe plastic or porcelain. I think it's plastic, but still, it's fine. Solid surface countertops, same as the kitchen. It's got a double kind of mirror system up here, or what do you call it, medicine cabinet.
Yeah.
Four drawers on the side and one cupboard down here. Plenty of storage for the bathroom.
Entry to the bedroom there.
Coming through into the bedroom. Bedroom's pretty nice too. There's a another TV in here, high def TV, which we really don't care too much about a TV in a bedroom, but
it's there.
You've got a nice four drawer chest right here at the foot, which is two times as many drawers as what I'm used to having. And then when you look into the closet area over here, right? So there's plenty of storage. This is easily five times the amount of closet space that we have now, if not more than that. This is where we're at now. We've each got a closet about yay so wide. And then on top of that, right here, you have more closet space and or washer dryer hookup. Good size king bed, full size king mattress. It flips up with more storage underneath, and it has the assist, so no issues there. And the mattress is not bad for a camper mattress. You know, I'm sure after a while we'll end up getting another mattress, but that's the way RVs are made. So pretty nice inside and out.
Yes, so excited now to think about it. today we had a nice tour of RVs.
We did.
And so we have the paper here of the price, what they'll give us for our trade-in here, which was excellent.
Which was really good.
It was a good trade-in.
I mean, you always hear people talk about depreciation in trailers and stuff, and they actually gave us pretty good. I mean, we only are losing about $9,000 over a 3-year lifespan that we've had this trailer.
So the questions that I was having was, there's another trailer on the lot that is 5 feet shorter?
So, yeah, 5 feet shorter.
5 feet shorter.
It's 36 feet versus 41.
$6,000 less. But this is my only home. So is $6,000 and 5 feet worth it? Or should I continue with my larger one, knowing that we can afford with no problem the larger trailer? So I guess the other question is what type of campgrounds, campsites can we go to with this large fifth wheel trailer?
National parks are pretty much out of the question, but most people, I think, like to stay outside the national parks and then travel into the national parks because different resources are available.
Yeah.
Most national parks, from what I understand, I may be wrong, probably don't have full hookup services and stuff available. Now, there's a convenience of already being in the park versus of being just outside the park. But where we're looking at full-time living and work camping,
we enjoy
getting
out of the trailer, having that little bit of community
conversation,
interactions, and stuff like that. So work camping has been really cool so far.
The only downside to work camping so far has just been our trailer.
Yeah.
And it's not a big downside. It's just a downside. And
right.
That's because the seating's not designed for full-time living.
Yeah.
You know, I mean,
this is a great trailer for weekend use.
Yep, it's a great trailer.
It's not
a
great trailer for full-time.
It's a great trailer if you're going to do weekends. It's a great trailer if you're going to do maybe a 1 or 2 week vacation.
Yeah.
Is this a good decision? Should we consider a shorter trailer, you know, that 5 feet?
Yeah.
Pros and cons. And it's a tough question. You know,
yes. My personal thought when I looked at both of them side by side, my personal thought was I liked the division between the kitchen and the living room, but you still had the conversation where if people were in the living room, you could still, you know, if you had guests or over or whatever, you could still be part of a conversation while somebody's cooking. Because as we all know,
everybody goes to the kitchen.
Everybody always is attracted to that kitchen. And so it would be, I think, a little bit, I don't know, more comfortable.
I think it'd be a little bit better for, I know it would be better for entertainment.
Do something.
And we have great relationships with our families.
Yeah.
Both of our kids are already talking about scheduling vacations to come and visit.
Yep.
Alice's dad is talking about scheduling time to
he
come and visit.
He gets the slide underneath the trailer. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm good with that. But, you know, when we have people come and visit, we want to have space to where they feel comfortable. And this trailer, we could do that because we did do that with Heather. We've taken a week and a half vacation. With Craig, we took a vacation.
But those up there, we've never utilized those cabinets on our weekend trips. And so that was where everybody would put, the extra person would put their stuff,
their clothes
would be up there. Because the only thing that we ever really stored up there on our weekend adventures were towels.
Or board games.
So there was plenty of room.
Up front, you've got your generator. It's 5,500. That'll be enough power to run AC unit, microwave, water heater, fridge, all that stuff. With the generator on, you can also recharge your batteries.
Okay.
Next time we got dry camping, it'll run all your 110 appliances as well. So, unless you're plugging into shore power or have your generator running, you won't be able to run 110. I'm sure you're kind of familiar with that.
Yep.
So, you have two breakers on it, about 30 amps. So it does not fire, just check those two breakers.
All right.
You do have a start stop on the inside right here.
Okay.
But there's also a switch on the inside, of the unit for you to fire it up.
Okay, so we are in a place called Brannigan's Irish Pub in Kalispell, Montana. A friend of mine, co-worker, said he came here for dinner the other day or lunch, and it was really good, so here we are.
Because we didn't buy anything.
Haven't bought a thing yet.
At Hobby Lobby.
Correct.
I found some cute little plants that I liked, but that was about it.
Some nice pillows.
Oh yeah, the pillows.
Pillow set for the couches.
But we walked out of there with nothing.
Nothing. Ideas.
Ideas. We have a lot of great ideas.
A lot of great ideas.
Oh, but the must-haves for today, nothing.
Nothing.
So, it was pretty good.
New beginnings, beginning again. Or Kenny, if you're watching this, Slanja.
We just filled that up. Look at that. Lordy, lordy.
Good thing we didn't go with the small one.
Oh yeah. Half of that stuff will go inside the trailer and have empty boxes in there when we're done. That's just temporarily.
More than half, because like four of these totes are just clothes and stuff. All the clothes will go in a closet.
Yep.
The shoes, there's a tote or two with shoes. Those will go in the closet. So most of this is going to go away. I've got my two generators that I used to use for my other trailer. Those will go away. So there's a lot of this stuff that we're not really going to have long term, especially the totes. We'll keep the totes because they make great storage. Or we may update totes just to find totes that we can stack on top of each other or something.
But they'll be empty. It is time to move in. Let's get this process.
Wait.
Where everybody knows me. Oh, 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 oh. First time doing it all by ourselves. Manual, there you go. And then front. I think you have to hold it.
I think it moved a little bit.
That one went down over there.
Well, my hitch is not undone either. I'm gonna pull forward now.
Okay.
Everything's unhooked, right? Nothing else is connected.
That's not connected. There you go, hang that on there. Perfect. Yay!